My name is David Strayer, and I'm a psychologist. I study cognitive neuroscience. That's the study of thinking, memory, perception, decision making, and trying to understand how the brain is responsible for those behaviors. It's science in action. When I started working, I worked in telecommunications, just when cell phones were starting to become popular. And at that time, it was pretty clear that you could become sufficiently distracted by the use of cell phone technology when you're trying to drive a car. So I've been studying driver distraction, looking at what we understand about attention and how the brain can multitask, how that relates to our everyday behaviors driving an automobile.
You can go ahead and start the car now.
Why I love this job is I can basically ask any question I want about what makes us tick and how we behave and use research methods and the scientific method to be able to answer those questions. That means observing, making hypotheses, designing experiments and testing them. A lot of times people think if your eyes are on the road and your hands are on the wheel, you'll be fine. But if you use a cell phone, is that something that actually harms driving behavior? And how does it differ from other things like listening to a radio or talking to a passenger? We're interested in things like handheld and hands-free cell phones. How do those differ? We found that if you talk on a cell phone, you're 4 times more likely to be involved in a crash. That's the same crash risk as if you were driving at a 0.08 blood alcohol level, if you're drunk. Worse is if you're texting. You're 8 times more likely to be involved in a crash. That's substantially worse than the drunk driver. We're looking now at some of the voice-based technologies.
Hello, Siri. Read appointments.
What we, I think, have learned is that some of these voice-based technologies are putting demands on the brain to try and multitask in ways that exceed the capacity to be able to do that activity and drive safely. We know that the research that's come out of my laboratory has been influential in changing regulatory policies and laws. At this point, 41 states in the United States now have laws that make it against the law to text while driving. There's a number of multinational, multi-billion dollar companies that have taken the research that we've collected and have used that as a basis for policies for not using their cell phones while driving. They substantially reduced the total number of crashes for their employees, and there was no loss in productivity. At the end of the day, we would hope that you're gonna see fewer fatalities on the roadway because people are not distracted. That's taking psychology and translating it directly into action. That's science in action.